Dave Parody of ThinkOutsideTheSlide.com here. I want to show you a quick preview in this video of what you're going to learn at the Presenting Financial Information Visually in PowerPoint, hands-on tools and techniques workshop that I'm going to be holding. So what I did is I just went and Googled some presentations that have financial information in them, just to see if I could find some examples that I'd never done before to show you how easy it is to create effective executive level visuals from the financial information that we typically have to present. So I found some examples I want to show you in this video. So let's start with this one. And I love this one because it's such a typical example. They just took the whole spreadsheet and copied it onto the slide. And the audience is overwhelmed. They're looking at it going, what the heck are we supposed to figure out? Well, there's some text up at the top there. It's actually a paragraph. And so you have to kind of figure out what's going on and then try and find in that spreadsheet somewhere some numbers that support the information that they're talking about. This is a classic information overload situation. And when I looked at this, as we start with every single discussion of what visual would be most effective, is what's the message that you're trying to communicate? In this case, they're trying to communicate two related messages. One is how much of the money is going to be spent on one group as opposed to another group, and how much money is going to be spent in the first 2 years as opposed to future years. So if those are the messages, one of the great visuals you can use is this, a donut graph. And whenever you're showing proportions, a donut graph is a great way sometimes to show it. In this case, it works well because there are only two segments to it. And the other thing I like about a donut graph is that you can put a message in that hollow middle, the empty area there in the middle. So you're able to reinforce what the key message is that the graph is showing. So we're going to show you in the workshop how to create donut graphs and how to use them effectively. So that's our first example. Our next example is someone who's actually using a graph. And people go, well, I'll just use a graph in PowerPoint because then, you know, that solves all the problems. Well, in this case, we're going to see that there's actually a better way to show this. What they're trying to show here is that the prescription products, that's what RX stands for those of you not familiar with that term, prescription products that are potentially an issue because they have they're going to come off of patent, they're only a very small proportion of the overall projected revenue. So there's not a lot of risk here. That's what they're trying to show. But the second pie graph on the right there actually shows a fairly significant size. Well, that's because it's a portion of that 41% pie wedge on the left. In this particular case, especially when you're breaking down one proportion into segments, much better than pie graphs is to use proportional shape. So here's how I redid this slide. First thing we're going to look at is how does our revenue break down into the different categories. So you can see our largest are prescriptions at 41%, and then you see the others. Now, when we look at the prescriptions at 41%, we'll see that only 24% of that group, or only 10% of the total, is actually at risk to this patent issue. By using a proportional shape diagram, we can see these proportions much easier and make that comparison much quicker for the audience. So there's a couple different ways to create this particular type of visual, and I'm going to show you two of those ways when we get into the workshop. So that's example number two. Example number three, we're going to go back to a spreadsheet. This is a classic example. A lot of financial presentations have to show where did we start, in this particular, the fund balance, what made it go up or down, and then what's the ending balance. This is very, very common in financial presentations, and often this is exactly how it's presented. We just copy the spreadsheet onto the slide. There's a much better way to show that, and that's using a waterfall graph. So here's how I redid it. If we take a look at the balance in this fund, we start the year with a $4.8 million deficit. Our income is going to be $59.3 million, so that gets us above, but our expenses are $43.4 million. But we also have obligations of $33.8 million, so it leaves our fund at the end at a deficit position of $22.7 million. This is a waterfall graph. It's a very effective way to show the components of a change between a starting and an ending amount or balance. And I'm going to show you exactly how to create these graphs simply and easily, because if you have to hand calculate how this gets created, it's difficult. But I've got a tool I'm going to show you that's free that easily does these calculations for you. Copy and paste, format it, and you're done. This is a stacked column graph, by the way, in just case you're wondering. And it's just all about calculating how do the stacks get shown and then set. So I'm going to show you exactly how to create a waterfall graph in the workshop. And our final example I want to show you in this video is this one. And again, this is a graph, and somebody says, oh, well, I'm going to put all the data on the graph. And again, it's overwhelming. Your eye doesn't really know where to go. This is another good example of where people make a mistake, and they have two messages on this slide. The first message are those bright yellow boxes at the top of each of the columns saying, see how the overall total has changed. And so that should be on one slide, and the columns should not be broken up. It should simply show, here are the columns and here's how the spending has changed. But if you wanted to show how the segments within that total column have changed, showing it as a stacked column graph really doesn't work very well. It's hard to see the columns because where they start changes, where they end changes, because the column below changes. It's very difficult. Instead, I'm going to show you how to create a very clean, effective graph. This is a line graph that shows each of the segments and their spending across the years. And now we can see the real big jump has been in that infrastructure yellow line. The others have not really increased all that much. So when you talk about the increase overall, it's really due to that one line. And in fact, maybe the other ones have dropped and that spending has been reallocated because the overall total didn't go up dramatically. Now we can discuss this message of, is this the right split between these particular groupings? I'm going to show you in the workshop how to create very clean and effective graphs from within PowerPoint, because the default graphs that we see are often confusing. If you've liked what you've seen, these makeovers, and you want to learn how to create these type of effective visuals for executive presentations, then go to www.makenumbersvisual.com. You're going to see all the details for this workshop, what cities it's coming to, and the specific dates. I look forward to seeing you at one of the workshops.